What's up, everybody? I hope you're doing well. It's been a while since my last video, and in today's video, I'm going to cover how to do winged eyeliner. Now, let me start off by saying winged eyeliner is definitely a bit difficult, and practice makes perfect. I know I say that all the time in my videos, but this is so especially true when it comes to winged eyeliner in particular. Sometimes you're gonna get it on the first try and it's gonna be amazing. Other times you might have to restart. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So for this winged eyeliner look, I'm just using any old eyeliner that I kind of just had laying around. I prefer to use something that has a felt tip because I think you can get a little bit more precise when you're doing your eyeliner. And I personally like to do just regular old black eyeliner, but these days different color eyeliners are super popular. So feel free to use whatever you feel most comfortable with. But again, I would recommend something with a felt tip. First thing I'm going to do is look at where the corner of my eye is and then kind of measure out in my head where the angle of my wing is going to be. So I like to use the end of my eyebrow as a guide. What I saw on TikTok, which I thought was like a great tip, was to map out some dots and then just connect the dots and fill in. So what I'm gonna do first is map out the dot here, which is just about where like the dark circle part of your eye, I believe, what is that called? The iris or something like that? So on the inner line of the iris, I'm gonna make a dot, cause that's about where my wing, or rather where my liner is gonna come to. And then I'm going to make another dot in the corner of my eye over here. And then finally, I'm going to I accidentally made a mark there, but I'm going to make another dot. So we can kind of see, okay, my liner is going to line this part of my eye and connect with this dot. And then we're gonna bring the wing out here. So let's get started. First, I really just take it slow. I do little strokes. To me, the shorter strokes are just a little bit easier to control. And then I'll get into the wing part itself more specifically. Another helpful tip that I've learned is to not just have your hand free floating as you're doing the line. I caught myself starting to do that, but if you just kind of lay your pinky down or give yourself as you're going a little bit of like a base, you'll have a more sturdy and like solid foundation as you're doing your line. And also I want to say that a lot of times people use tape to help them map out where their wing is going to go. And also it allows you to be a little bit messier. And when you take the tape off, it'll just give you a really nice like cut wing. So that is also an option. But as you can see here, I made my first line. So from this dot to this dot, I'm gonna start by kind of doing little flicks. And then I'm going to like color it in. And you'll see what I mean as I go. So from here, and then as I get to my dot, I kinda wanna continue the flick so that you get that nice cut. And see, right now it's not perfect, but we'll fill it in, we'll work it out, and practice makes perfect, right? Okay, so now from here, I have like the base of the wing, and then I'm kind of gonna tilt my face a little bit, and I'm gonna connect this end of the wing and draw a line from about the middle of my eye over, and that's what we're gonna fill in. Then, once that's done, I'm gonna just go back and redraw my line and just start it a little bit closer to the corner of my eye. And then, repeat on the other side. Okay, and now I have both eyes done, and let me tell you, in the spirit of full transparency, when I was doing this left eye, I really messed up. It was just a disaster. So I just took it off and redid it, and honestly, this one looks ever so slightly different than this one, but not enough to really make a difference or change up the look at all. It's not drastic, but that just goes to show you that practice makes perfect, and you are likely going to mess up. That's just the facts. But redo it and just keep trying and trying and trying. It'll eventually come easier and easier and easier to you. So this is both eyes done. And again, just to review the steps, what I like to do is map out the dots. Beginning of where the outline of my eye color is. At the end, and then where I want my wing to end. And then I draw my line over my lid, flick outwards, come back and connect and fill in, and then go back in again and just extend the wing to be closer to the corner of my eye. To reiterate, you can also use tape for this to help with the shape of the wing. And remember that the angle, the shape, the length, everything is going to vary depending upon what you think looks best on you and what you are most comfortable with. So, with all of that being said, oh, one last thing I want to mention is you can also use eyeshadow to do this. You can get a compact bristle eyeshadow brush and smoke it out and line, you know, the your lash line and then smoke out a wing. There are so many different ways you can do this, but this is just a basic liquid eyeliner winged tutorial. So I'm gonna finish getting ready and I'll show you the final look. And this is the final look. So everybody, thank you so much for tuning into this video. I hope you found it helpful. Go give this a try, and I will see you next time.